Good evening. I'm Lourdes Lopez and the Artistic Director for Miami City Ballet. And welcome to Miami City Ballet's Cocktails in Countless Spaces. It's so nice of you to join us. This evening, we have Miami City Ballet principal dancers Katia Carranza and Kleber Rebello. And we'll be talking about their roles in Nine Sinatra Songs, a work that was choreographed by choreographer Twyla Tharp, and one that actually Miami City Ballet just performed this last season. The ballet was choreographed in 1984, and in it, Twyla uses Frank Sinatra recordings from the 1960s. Her approach to these songs and to Sinatra's smooth musical style is full of flair, sophistication, and at times even mockery. Twyla's choreographic genius comes out, however, in how she seamlessly blends ballroom dancing with ballet vocabulary, all to depict different relationships. So, Katia and Kleber, welcome, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
I think before we start, Kleber, I just want to say how much I love your hair. For those of you that have known you for a long time, it's actually very becoming.
It's very different now. I look in the mirror and I'm just like, missing something darker up here. It's like, I should have picked a little bit.
I don't know. It's a brand new you.
Thanks.
Anyway, let's talk a little bit about your roles in Nine Sinatra Songs. But first of all, Frank Sinatra is an American singer and songwriter and actor from the 1930s to the early 1990s. And knowing where both of you came from, Katia, you're from Mexico, and Kleber, you're from Brazil. How much contact did you come in with directly with Frank Sinatra's movies or his songs? I mean, how much did he influence you growing up? I'm assuming not much, but Katia, why don't we start with you?
When I was younger, I just know maybe some of the songs because of my parents, because I think, you know, people from just his generation feels very identified with his music, and it reflects a golden age. But I don't really have much contact until we danced Nine Sinatra, this ballet. So I really, you know, have a little bit more information about his career as a singer. But I know some of these songs before, and I know in Mexico many people know Frank Sinatra's music because of what he's, you know, reflecting in these times. But I really have more contact now.
Kleber, what about you?
For me, it was kind of the same. I had a little bit of contact with his music. You know, when I was younger, I would always hear it in the back, maybe like at shopping malls or during Christmas. They would play a lot of really good, you know, old songs. But it wasn't really like Katia. It wasn't until I got to perform and learn and dance Nine Sinatra that I really learned his songs and, you know, all those captivating lyrics. You know, you can't go wrong with that.
But I think Sinatra's lyrics are very romantic, and it makes me feel so in love. And this is something very important, because I think it's easier for me to enjoy when I'm dancing and what I want to communicate with my partner or even with the audience to get it. So I think for me it's easier to have these lyrics on the music, and it makes me enjoy more what I'm doing.
That's actually a perfect segue into the partnering of Twyla's work, which is her partnering is always rather difficult, and even more so difficult, I think, in all of Nine Sinatra Songs, because a lot of it is ballroom, but specifically in Nat's Life, which is the pas de deux that both of you do, which always steals the show at the end of Nine Sinatra Songs. There's a lot of trust, and I'm going to go first with Katia. There's a lot of trust, Katia, that you have to have in your partner, because you're literally throwing yourself, right, towards him in sometimes blindly, right? So talk a little bit about that, because it's tremendous risk taking, but it is part of the work, and it only works if the female dancer has complete trust in her male partner.
Definitely. I think at the beginning, when we start learning or we start rehearsing together, we work every day to get this connection and you know, feel comfortable with the movements and the lift and all these risks that we have in the choreography. But with Kleber, I feel very secure. Like, he's an amazing partner. He's a dancer who has so much passion on stage. And something that I love to dance with him, especially this ballet, is that every time we go and we perform, he does something different. He's just like these dancers that surprise you with different timing or another eye contact that he never did before. But I think that makes the pas de deux very fantastic and enjoyable to dance. But it's true, I have to really trust him, and I do totally. He's this kind of partner that he's always worried about the dancer and about me the whole time. So I just go out, wait for him to see what he's gonna do, and enjoy myself. So
Kleber, you want to respond to that? I mean, I don't know.
I have to say, honestly, when I wasn't Katia's first partner for this pas de deux, so I was very nervous to start, because I felt like, looking at it, I felt like, okay, those are complicated lifts and drags and all this stuff, all the partnering stuff, but it's not super technically hard, so I thought. As soon as we got to do it, I realized that it was actually 10 times harder than I thought. It's much faster. And I was nervous because she was so confident and she knew exactly what to do. She knew the times and the tempos and how much to throw, and that she helped me so much with it.
I want to talk about my favorite part practically in the entire ballet, which is in your pas de deux. That's at the very, very end when the female dancer, Katia, in this respect, walks away from Kleber. And someone from backstage throws your tuxedo jacket back to you, right? And as you're putting on your tuxedo jacket, Katia flings herself in the air. So I want you both to talk a little bit about that, because there are moments where Katia is actually in the air, Kleber, and you haven't gotten your jacket on. So that timing to me almost seems like a trapeze type of timing, like trapeze artist, right, in the circus that have this. So talk about that, because that's just, it's phenomenal, that last moment.
And also, as much as you're comfortable with it, you have to make it look like it's very last minute too. So even if you get your jacket in before, which takes a little bit of time and you have not, basically, you have to make it look like you don't have it in enough time. And then she's just jumping into you. Maybe the jacket, the sleeve is caught in your hand and you don't know what to do. It kind of happens all the time. Mm-hmm. It is a weird moment, but you have to keep your cool and go with it. And I look at Katya's face and she's always calm. So like, it's going to work out. It's okay.
Is that true, Katya? Are you always calm?
Well, first of all, I walk away. So I really can see, you know, if I'm okay with the timing to just, but I have my timing to, you know, turn back and just run. So every time I do, I try not to see what he's doing, not to put myself nervous. So I just turn and pretend that I'm super comfy. No, I really are. I mean, I know he's going to take me no matter what. And I never really feel that he's, you know, not ready for it, because he's there standing, even if he don't have his jacket already. He look at me like, you're fine, just come. So I just run and jump. And thanks God, we always, you know, we never have a bad experience in that part, but it's a nice part.
We look at each other in the eye, we're like, we're gonna do it.
Yes.
Well, I have to tell you, it works, as the audience has their heart in their throats during this.
We have it for a split second too.
Well, my last question for you is going back a little bit to what Katia spoke about at the beginning of the interview, which is the romance really behind this entire work of Twyla's Nine Sinatra Songs. So here we are in Miami, probably one of the most romantic cities in the United States. So what do you do for romance? What do you do for, well, once we get past COVID, what do you do for romance and an evening out?
To me, is to be with the right person. and maybe just a nice dinner or a, you know, just a walk in the beach or something, it makes it like a totally my romance night. But the most important is to be with the right person. It can be your family and or your partner or, you know, somebody that you love.
And Kleber?
I think Miami, kind of like you said, Lourdes, I think it is a romantic city because there is, you know, there's the beach, there's the sun, there's beautiful places to go, beautiful places to take people you love, and culture for unity, to people to be together and either, you know, together at parties or together at gatherings or the restaurants, that many restaurants that we have here, you know, looking over the ocean. I think you can get any more romantic than that.
Well, thank you both. I look forward to taking you both out to dinner as a thank you for doing this in one of, in a romantic place in Miami. Mm-hmm. I send you my love. I so look forward to having you guys in the studio. And thank you for joining us. And thank you all for joining us and being part of Cocktails in Countless Spaces.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
That's life.
That's life.
That's what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June.